playing against the count one to call.
Point! 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 Point!
What's gone right for Papio South in 2019?
I think that we're very close together, and we're all rooting for each other and working together. I think that that's our team. Chemistry is the best it's been in a couple years.
How different is 2-0 in 2019 as compared to starting the year 2-0 in 2018?
It just feels different. We still got a lot to do, and get better though.
For you personally, how do you feel the season started, just two games?
I think that I'm helping a lot in the run game, and I feel super pumped about the next games to come, but I still think we got a lot of proof.
Where do you feel you have grown maybe the most in the last year? Coach told me that you put on about 30-35 pounds in the offseason.
I got a lot faster, I'm a lot stronger, I'm moving people on the line, my speed's helping me in pass routes and catching.
People who have never seen you play, how would you describe your game?
I can think of myself like being unselfish. It's like help blocking, springing runs, and I'm not really looking for stats, just looking to win with my team.
Your coach said that he kind of calls you a throwback player, more a traditional tight end. When you hear that description, what comes to mind?
So like, I guess like today a tight end would be like described as a like super athletic, making plays, and kind of more of a receiver. But I think that I'm helping a ton with the run game and kind of acting, not like a tackle, but hand in the dirt, blocking people a lot.
I guess you said there's
there's not necessarily numbers you're chasing this year. What would constitute a successful season? What do you want to get out of this season?
Making the playoffs, trying to go deep, just feeling satisfied with the work we did during the year.
When you look at yourself kind of as a tight end and what the next couple years would look like, where do you feel maybe you need to improve the most at?
I still think I can put a lot more weight on. I think that my skills in the pass game can improve. I think that I run hard after the catch, but just ball skills and just being more aggressive and stuff.
I want to talk a little bit. We talked a little bit on the summer, but the rise you had in 2 weeks, I guess kind of take me through that whirlwind, if you wouldn't mind.
I was just preparing to go out to the Lindenwood camp and put myself on the map, show coaches what I could do, and it just it took off way faster than I thought, and picked a bunch of offers, and then went to Kansas State. They offered me. I love the coaches, and I feel like it's a place that I want to play at. So I committed there, and now I'm just focusing on the high school team and hopefully winning a lot of games.
I guess, did you go in feeling like, yeah, I could be a Division I football player when you go to that camp?
I guess I did it catch you by surprise.
I mean, like, it wasn't like comparison traps, but I was seeing guys who were getting offers and stuff like that at the tight end position, and I thought I can do just as much as them, if not better. And I never doubted myself. I just needed to go out and do it.
In in an era where it seems like everybody is getting recruited when they're like a freshman or sophomore. I guess what's to say about you and kind of your perseverance to, you know, there are a lot of guys that maybe as a sophomore or junior, if they don't have a scholarship offer, they say, to hell with it, I'm done even playing football. I guess that's got to say something about kind of your perseverance, right?
Oh, yeah, I would say it's like kind of the opposite. Like, I didn't think about playing college football as a sophomore or junior. I mean, I did, but it wasn't didn't look attainable for me. And then when I put all that weight on and stuff, I just, before my, right after my junior year, I was really committed to trying to put on a lot of weight, and it worked out great, and now I got all this going for me.
Do you ever look back and be like, man, that 2 weeks changed my life?
Yeah, there I got these, I got the camp shirts that I was, I haven't worn them anywhere. I was just going through the laundry and stuff, pulling out the camp shirts that I went to. It was like that. That's what started all of this.
I want to ask about K-State real quick. I guess what was it the deciding factor? They've been a powerhouse before. I guess what was the deciding factor that said, yeah, this is the spot. This is where I want to play college football.
So when I learned that Coach Kleinem and all those coaches didn't step down, but went over to Kansas State, I really liked the NDSU offense, and I think that's the type of tight end that I can play. And when I went down to their games, it proved that I think that's a perfect place for me. It's close to home, the coaches were awesome, and the facilities are great, and I just thought it was an awesome school.
I gotta ask, am I right? Coach was saying that you come out here to practice, you get right on time just because you're taking classes. Are you graduating in December?
I'm graduating in December and enrolling early.
What goes into that decision? Because there's some guys that want to kind of live out high school.
Yeah, so, I mean, it was kind of a tough decision, but last year I played baseball. And I was a pitcher. I didn't do too awesome. I mean, I love baseball, but I think that my want to get ready for the football season outgrows that want to play baseball.
I guess with knowing then that your high school career just in general is coming to an end, how much emphasis, how much urgency do you have on this season?
I'm not worried about that right now. I'm just focusing right now, but just like talking to my friends about how like I'll be gone in December and January, and it's just like a whole half year is I'm not going to be around here anymore. So it's just I'm really focused on this football season and winning games.
Kind of making the most of,
yep.
of the
yep.
time you have remaining here. Cool.